was you doing in the band though?
I was just definitely doing something that was crazy.
I don't, like, I know who David Blaine is, but I don't. Like, if you show me a picture of him or something, I wouldn't know who he is.
But I know the song. I remember me saying that, like, a lot.
What's the song? What's going on, peeps? Craig Mitch here, Link Up TV. We're joined by K-Trap, Headie One. Obviously, Strength to Strength is out now. How's it going, lads?
Good.
Okay.
What are you saying? Wow. You look tired.
Yeah, we're tired.
It's been a long day.
I know. I'm doing FOMO wrong, man.
We're still lively.
All right, let's go for it. I'm going to start with you, Trappo. So, slap bro if he brings his phone on a ride. Are you trying to get us birded or what?
Yeah.
You got to finish it, though. And then we'll say
the name of the Slap bro brings his phone on a ride. Your tongue gets banned. AJ, that's a bird on the top.
Slim fit
kind of prop.
Jeez.
Yeah.
What song was it?
Khan's Freestyle.
That's, yeah, Family First, yeah. Khan's Hill Freestyle. Yeah. What can you tell us about that song though?
That's like the start of like K-Trap really. The start like where more people was aware of me. I was at Khan's, I went upstairs, I tried the idea. I left it there, and if anyone knows Khan's will just take the song and put it out.
Yeah.
And that's what he done, and people liked it.
And it's mad because you still work with him to this day.
Yeah.
Both of you, innit? He's on this new tape as well.
Yeah, Parching War, that's Khan's.
Crazy. Like, Headie, let's come to you, my guy. Let's go in with you. All right, this one is, was trying to get my prints off the head thing. You couldn't keep your prints off Bel Air like Philip.
Oh.
I was trying to get my prints off the head thing. You couldn't keep your prints off Bel Air like Philip. Do you remember the rest of the bar?
Something about years in the VIP section drinking. I was on the back road.
Close.
He was in the VIP section drinking.
I was in the
bando. In a band, though.
What were you doing in the band, though?
I was just definitely doing something that was crazy.
Flipping.
Yeah.
He was in the band, though, flipping. But what was that from? It was a freestyle as well.
Did we get any inkling? Yeah. Oh, that might be Limelight. Is that Limelight Freestyle?
Nah, it was Street Heat Freestyle. Oh, that was actually on Link Up TV.
Yeah.
It's come full circle. Yeah,
crazy. I'm right here, right now.
Mad. But let me ask you lots of something. Do you write or do you just go in there and spit? Like, what's your process when it comes to coming up with lyrics?
I write still.
Right, yeah?
Yeah.
Pen or phone?
Phone, yeah.
You don't take it old school with a pen and pad?
No, I have, but nah.
Nah. Yeah. What about you?
Honestly, my more natural thing to do is to write. If the time permits, isn't it? Like in the studio, I'm just writing more time. But obviously, I like to just like, it just depends how I'm feeling. It's catch a vibe. Sometimes I sit with a beat and just listen to the beat for long enough as well, so yeah.
Have you ever done it where you've just done it in your head, like on a 104 now?
Maybe like 2 bar, 4 bar, something. Just
okay.
I just say it, and then I'm like, oh yeah, this is hard, but not really.
Rappers love saying that one, though, innit?
I'm not perfectionist.
They want to be like home. They're like, yeah, just come over here in my head. These
things
are just writing
in. Yeah, no, I write still.
I hear it. Why not? All right, Trap, back to you. No face, no case. When I'm banging, get it done. Like, who's gonna know?
I play Ace when I'm trapping. Hit the street like Fee's Got a Goal.
What song is it?
David Blaine,
man. What can you tell us about that song?
What can I tell you about David Blaine? That's like, I think like the people's favourite, man.
Yeah.
You get me? Like anyone that's an old K-Trap supporter, that's the people's favourite. I think that was on Link Up, didn't it? Yeah, it was on Link Up. Yeah, man, that's the beginning of things still.
Whatever happened to David Blaine? What happened to Donnie?
Oh, the actual man.
The actual guy, what happened to him? He used to be up in the box, remember?
You know, so mad, yeah. I don't, like, I know who David Blaine is, but I don't. Like, if you show me a picture of him or something, I wouldn't know who he is.
Like,
I just know what he does.
In the street.
Yeah, I just know what he does still.
Magician, innit?
Yeah.
All right, H, has come to you. I done the wrong type of touring. Association in the morning. All the accents northern.
I know it, but I don't know it, man. You know, like, I do know it though. But
you
right.
I remember.
I can remember.
I said two-thirds of it for you.
But what it is, you know, like when you're saying the lines, yeah, and that's it, like.
Oh, it's on me. It's the way I'm saying it.
Nah, it's not even on you, but it's like, cause it's like, I don't know the start I'm playing with as halfway through a lyric, so I'm struggling to like catch the flow and continue it. But I know the song. I remember me saying that like a lot.
What's the song? Alright, the song's Ganging with RV. So it basically goes, I done the wrong type of touring, association in the morning, all the accents northern, still man approach with
caution.
Caution. Yeah, right, of course. Shout out to RV. Alright, cool. We'll come over to you, Trap. Still gotta keep a lookout because the pigs they're observing.
No, man. I'm lost, bro.
Alright, so you said still gotta keep a lookout because the pigs they're observing. Nothing ain't overnight. Look at all the times it weren't working. And that was on Flying Straight.
Oh, Flying Straight. Yeah, you're taking it back still.
Still ain't forgot how it feels to be losing. They thought it was permanent. Found it amusing. No, you gotta have the...
Yeah, his ones are kind of hard though.
Tough, man.
This ain't hard. This is a big song.
Something that feels to be losing. So can you repeat it one more time for me, please, bro?
You said, still ain't forgot how it feels to be losing. They thought it was permanent, found it amusing.
Charades, Fred again.
It then goes, now they strip on me like I'm...
Canoeing.
Bro, is a bar as well. Like,
I know, but this is... it's not in my memory right now.
That was you and Drake on Only You Freestyle.
No way, what? I didn't say that.
No, you didn't say that.
Who wrote this?
Yeah,
who wrote this?
Did I say that?
Yeah, you know, went who wrong. You definitely didn't say that. You didn't
who wrote
say
it?
That. Nah, I think oh, no. This is a trick question, this one.
That's what it says here. It says Only You Freestyle Drake.
No, you know why though? Because that's when I've done like the little melody thing.
What do you mean?
That isn't it? Yeah. Oh, see, you got me.
Wait, what?
What do you mean? You know, like, because I didn't rap it.
Yeah.
You know what? It's like at the end, towards when the song, my verse is about to finish.
Oh.
I started doing a little melody.
Ah,
yeah, so naturally, I'm not really thinking that about a melody.
Okay, wait, say it again.
He said, still ain't forgot about how it feels to be losing. They thought it was permanent, found it amusing. Now this drip on me like I'm canoeing.
It's like at the end of the verse and I started doing a little melody to it.
Oh, so you don't really perform that part then, like when you perform it?
No, you do, but I get why you wouldn't think. Yeah, now you said that, I know.
Yeah.
Okay, all right. Trap, before I get into the next one, quickly, when it comes to lyricism in the UK, who would you lot say, outside of yourselves, like who would you say is like one of your favourite UK lyricists? I'll start with you, H.
It depends what you mean by a lyricist.
Whatever you want it to mean. Whatever you want it to mean.
I'd say like, oh, you got some people that's like they got like good flows and that, mostly like bars, but there's some people that go deeper and like more clever with their words and like. So if you're saying like someone that's got like that's clever with their words, I'd say like Dave's like got like clever lines like lyrically, but then also you have like Potter Paper who's like a lyricist as well. But I'd say he's a different kind of lyricist to Dave.
What about you, Trapper?
I'll say Tef.
Tef,
yeah. He's kind of
a Tef's definitely a lyricist for sure. All right, cool. Come back to lyric quiz. Trapper, Uber. Are you even driving? When you're drunk, are you rude and end up fighting?
Are you on for the timing? Are you naturally swaggy or need some styling?
So talk to me about Interlude, because a lot of the Badinas I be chilling with, I can't lie, they play that song from time to time. They actually play that one. That was like, because obviously drill's more for the man them in general, innit? Obviously there's going to be girls that listen to drill, but when you make that song for the girls, what was the process behind it? Like, is it something you always wanted to do? How did that song even come about?
Literally that. Like, we were just in the studio and we said, I need to make a song for the girls.
Yeah.
And we just done that. I don't know. There wasn't really much to it. Like, we just felt like we needed a girl song for the project, but I didn't want to make like a slow jam, R&B, dancey kind of song. I just wanted to make something that the girls can rock with, but I'm still kind of just being me in it.
But It's a hard song as well, man. I like the way you approached it, and the video is cold as well.
Yeah, love
it. You went in with that one. I'll come back to you, H. What about this one? You ain't never made a birthday cake from digestive biscuits.
You never had a birthday cake. Wait, ain't different. I mean, I don't know where, but I heard something.
I know that, so if you don't know.
I passed the lyric, but you know, you never made a birthday cake from digestive biscuits. Still something, something.
Or have to lemon juice to a piss test. What's the next part?
Yeah.
Every day I look up to the Lord, give thanks for all the litness.
There we go. Cold. Hey, what song was that? Man. He got one though, he got one. Finally, we got there.
I'm happy with that one. That was
What song was that?
Ain't It Different.
Ain't It Different with Storms and AJ. Yeah, what can you tell us about that song? How did that come about?
That song was complicated, you know, because originally it was a different kind of song. Like, I was working with Fred again, and then like there was so much dynamics to the song. Like, there was singers on it and all that kind of stuff. And in the end, like, I just sent it to AJ.
Yeah.
Sent it to Storms, and then, yeah, I was with it, and, yeah. The song
like that was a nice. Big song as well. It was, like, a big moment at that time in your career.
Yeah, it was, definitely.
Let's talk about, like, just you lot's history as well, because when we go all the way back to No Combo, so all the way back to 2017, and then you got 2018, which was it Intent on your tape, the one, and then we get No Caller. How did you lot originally link up for that original song, No Combo? Was that the first song?
Yeah, No Combo
was the first song.
Yeah. I swear Intent was, so it wasn't.
No, I think it was No Combo.
Oh, No Combo.
So maybe you lot recorded Intent first, but No Combo came out first. I don't know, but...
I think it was No Combo.
Actually,
I remember.
Didn't we do Intent and No Combo at the same day?
Yeah, in the same year. Because we had there was like a studio. I went south.
Yeah.
And so we had like a studio session. Like, I can't remember the setup, but... It's not like the studios like nowadays,
No, I'm gonna paint the picture. What was it like?
It's like I pulled up to a room. Yeah, it's like
just a room.
Ganged off.
So when you so when you think about that, yeah, because that was only 6 years ago. When you think about it, yeah, 6 years can sound like a long time, but really, like, it's not. And what you man have accomplished in that time, like you just said, the studio, what it was like back then. Now you man are sitting here with like mad watches on, like you lot have done bits. Like, how would you describe that journey? Like, did you even think you could take it this far back then when you recorded it?
Back then, no.
Yeah.
Back then it was just, not saying that I didn't think we could take it that far, but that just I personally wasn't thinking that far, looking that far. Like, being in that studio, thinking about,
I feel like I was just aware of like obviously you had like dreams and that, you know what I'm trying to say?
Mm.
And obviously aspire to be somewhere better, but we're just a way of expressing ourselves, obviously, at the time, like, with everything that's going on, you know, like, if you come from a certain background,
yeah,
it's like a bit of a outlet, like, just trying a thing, innit? See what happens.
How did you lot realise you had, like, chemistry in the studio when it came to making music? Like, when did that click and you guys knew that?
I think the song that we've done, the first song.
From the
first song,
from the jump, still.
And how did you even link up? Like, how did that link up come about? Because you're from completely opposite ends of the compass.
It's mad.
I remember.
The link up was like, it was mad because like, how did link up? Yeah, I basically met everyone except from H. Yeah. But obviously like, H is the one rapping from there, you get what I'm trying to say? So when I'm bucking these lot, they're like, bro, you know about Headie, innit? You get me? But I knew about Headie from there. I listened to Headie, and it's mad because obviously on my side, yeah, we was listening to Headie, innit? So it's naturally, I just exchanged contacts or whatever with whoever it was and that, and then this was in another country. Then we got back to the UK and we just patterned up. We did them and they just come studio. Yeah, it was just easy, bro.
So it was just like a mutual respect for music.
Yeah,
as well.
Literally, yeah.
That's cold, man. And see you lot both come to where you are now. I'm going to get into the next one, but just before we do that, this tape, people have been waiting for this tape. Obviously, there's been like rumors for a while throughout the whole year. From last year, people have been talking about it potentially being a tape. What took so long? We're happy it's here, but like what took so long?
I feel like it could have happened any time, but I feel like now's a good time, man. Mm. Like, Yeah.
Definitely, yeah. And you know what's mad? Like, I can't lie, like, obviously, the times that we're in now, time just flies by. You know what I'm saying? Like, one little maneuver could happen. Like, I think I went on tour in that space of time, and then, like, that killed off a few months or whatnot. So it's just like, yeah, man, time's just flying by. But now it's that, like Chop was saying, it's the right time, innit?
Rapper boy, don't make me feel it.
Three whole pies and nine sandwich bags when I was zipping.
And what was the song?
Extra Time.
With you and Blade Brown.
Yeah.
You and Blade Brown got a good relationship as well. Obviously, yeah, you made music together on a project. Like, how did that relationship with Blade Brown come about?
A lot of relationships are through like Cons. Cons just had a studio.
Yeah.
And the maddest setup, like, you just don't know who you're gonna see at Cons is like, and that Blade and that Blade Teffin that always used to be recording downstairs. I used to be upstairs.
Mm.
Like, we didn't really used to mix, but used to hear their music or they'll hear my music and that. Yeah, we just always used to be in the same place, you get what I'm trying to say? And then, yeah, naturally we just patterned up, went studio and that. And then, yeah, getting to know Blade, the dots just connected, like, we basically was locked in before we was even locked in, do you get what I'm trying to say?
Yeah.
And then, yeah, it's just been official, like, we've just been patterning since.
Shout out to Blade, man, that's my guy as well.
Mm.
All right, cool. Finally, Headie, I'm going to come to you and I'm going to give you, because you've been struggling a little bit. Yeah. It's been a long day. It must be a long day. Yeah. I don't know what's going on. I know you got a lot of music. I
need to revive myself now.
All right, cool. We used to be on the phone for hours and all you would hear is Scottish folks.
No, I got it, you know.
Go ahead.
It's home.
But what was the next lyric?
You hear Scottish folks. Yeah, I don't know the next lyric.
But now we're in Europe.
It's a type of something to do with knots or something.
Nah. He said, we used to be on the phone for hours and all you hear is Scottish folks. Now we're in Europe making a pot like a jollof bowl.
What?
You're not here though, right? That's something you put in the lyric.
Is it? That must be like, you know when someone got the lyrics wrong on Genius and that.
Oh, you think so? Well, they're questioning the whoever wrote the lyric down.
That's sturdy though, but yeah, no. It would make it make sense, innit?
Make it make sense.
Jollof rice in a bowl. Stud.
Yeah, it works. Steady. It's definitely steady. All right, cool. Finally, just a couple more questions. M1 on the beat. Cole producer. You lot locked in with him a lot as well. What is it about M1's production? Because like, I definitely want to give some like spotlight to producers as well. What is it about his production, especially with like drill, that makes him so special for you, man?
M1, it's his intros. That's how he introduces the beat. It's how, it's how his intros are just cold, bro.
So like when he just like, if you're in the studio and he just plays you a beat, you can just kind of feel it straight away.
Yeah.
And he's got, I feel like M1's got like a specific, like when he decides to like make a certain type of beat, he's got like a very unique sound where, you know, it's him, you know what I'm trying to say? So,
yeah.
No,
he's done his thing, shout out to him. All right, cool. And then finally, strength to strength, man. Like, what do you think the fans can expect from this? And will there ever be a part two?
I think the fans can expect like a lot of like audacious lyrics. Like, yeah, I say flamboyance back to back. It's just like, it's like, that's the vibe that I get from it. It's just like in your face.
Yeah.
Yeah.
What about you, Trapper?
Yeah, same kind of, man. I just feel like, I don't even know how to explain it. I feel like you'll get a bit of that old school feel.
Mm.
I feel like the tape Defo like represents or shows like just how we was feeling at that time of making the tape. You get what I'm trying to say? Like our moods that time when we made the tape. And yeah, man, H and Trap in it. It's just, yeah.
Part two? Would ever be a part two? Am I pushing it?
Lord, energies of the universe. Know,
just has to align and see what happens.
Yeah, we'll see, man.
Yeah?
Yeah.
There you have it. The lyrics quiz. I'm not even sure who won. Well, I'll be real. Trap probably won on that one. Like, if it was a competition, you definitely won. I don't even know if this is a competition. We were just trying to test your knowledge, but you definitely won if it is. Shout out to you, man. Obviously, Strength to Strength is out now, so make sure you check that out. Man, it's been an absolute pleasure. Oh, all the best, honestly. Goku and Vegeta right here for me. And that's it, Link Up TV Lyric Quiz.